Hello, hello, and welcome to part 25 of this Let's Play in Japanese of Lapis Lab. Okay, so let's continue. We are reading the crap. Let's continue, yes. Okay, so it's about the fifth. The number 5. The number 5 empire. Do you want to read it? The fifth. I can't say it. Okay, let's see. Several thousands of years ago, there was a glorious empire, and that had a more powerful, bigger magic compared to the present time. Voilà, and it was raising. Voilà, it was the magic creatures that were raised. And the wizards were very strong, and they were able to control the world thanks to that. So they were maybe like, you know, wizards that were mounted on magical beasts. I don't know. Sounds cool. Okay, that's the cutscene. Okay. D'accord, I guess all the... Voilà, d'accord. Ah, d'accord. Due to the activities of the Demon King, the history of this world, you know, of the world of the Fifth Empire was extinguished from memories and from the world. Okay? The Fifth... Voilà, the people from the age of the Fifth... No. No, d'accord. The fifth people. What does it mean? Like the people from the fifth empire, or like where the people that made up the empire were called the fifth? No, like they were not humans, but the fifth. How can I pronounce that? How do you pronounce fifth? I'm going to say fifth. Voilà. The fifth people compared to the present to the modern day humans, modern day people were living way longer. More than anything, they were voilà, aside from fragments and from coins, there is nothing that remains from the fifth empire. But there is no doubt that there is some fifth people that are mixed along with the humans. What does it mean? Like, yes, okay. Basically, there is still some immortals among the humans, and they are not actually humans, but fifths. I guess something like that. Yes, probably. Wait, can I read that? No, okay. Okay, so let's check that. Okay, so magic and magic power. Do you want to read it? Yes. About magic power. No, about magic. It is when you say a specific, special words. Chaos word. Okay, so what is that? Okay, I shouldn't have closed the dictionary. Okay, I'm sorry. Yes, I feel a little guilty when I check the dictionary, but damn it, these videos are for me, not for you. If you like them, awesome. But you know, I need to use them to deepen my understanding of Japanese. And after all, if I search now, it means that I will not search in the future. Citation. So like it's incantation, I guess. Yeah. Voilà. Upon enumerating specific words, which are named chaos words, chaos words, and drawing very complicated magical circles, and you can call forth some mana, magic power, and using spells and magic circles, you can call forth a spiritual energy called mana and control it. Okay, magic is that. It's the ability to do all of that. Bon. The source of this energy is... D'accord. Because the source of the energy is the former demon people and nature, it means that... What? If you are cosplaying as the demon people or as nature, you can control it easier, is that it? Ah, I have no idea what they mean. They did not say anything about the cosplay, cosplay, but yeah. I have no idea, but maybe like it's related to the shape. Like if you have a specific shape, you can control magic more easily. I have no idea. Yeah, it's also confusing because you know the Japanese use Marioki and mana as it's basically the same thing. It's mana. Marioki is mana. It's magic power. Okay, let's see. Yes, so magic power and how do I say that? Marioki, Mahoryoku. Maho is magic. You know the ability, you know the craft of using magic, and Ryoku is power. So the power of crafting magic, and Marioki is magic. So the power of magic. So the power of magic and the power of casting magic, they are different. Magical power is using the mana stream and the mana. Is that it? Magic power draw. Like it's what? It's the difference between the sorcerers and the wizards in Dungeons and Dragons. Is that it? I have no idea. No, yeah. I guess maybe. Or whatever. Magic power is drawing force power from the mana stream and mana. Okay. Wizard power. Let's go with wizard power. Wizard power. I have no idea, but basically, wizard power is the ability to use mana to draw mana and use it in a way that is incomparable to just using magical power, isn't it? But the ability to do that varies from people to people. You know, there is individual differences. I have no idea. I think that it's that, yes. D'accord, the demon people are able to bestow some of their own magical power to other people, just like we saw, you know, with the thief. You know, the thief leader that was transformed into monsters because of that. The demon people are able to bestow magical power on mana, on other people. But it is impossible to forcefully steal it from living creatures. Okay. But other people. What? Ah, d'accord. So voilà, other people are not able to steal, to forcefully get the power from the demon people. But the demon people are able to steal the magical power from other people, even up to killing them. No, voilà. So it is good to kill them because the demon people, you know, like they are leeches, I guess. D'accord. The mana from someone that dies is getting to the atmosphere and before long join back, return to the mana stream. Okay. So like it's a vibe of Final Fantasy VII. Okay. So, yeah. Voilà, and I guess this thing, I guess, want to find another receptacle. Receptacle? No, another vessel, voilà, vessel. D'accord. Also, the Demon Knight is able to draw a mana from nature, which results in a totally different power. Okay. So you know, it have nothing to do with that. Like you know, we will talk about the Demon Knight and the mana from nature in another war. Okay. Okay. So basically, the Demon people are drawing power from people. They did that. Okay. But I don't understand the mana stream. Is that not a natural thing? Like people are they not a part of that nature? I guess by nature they mean, you know, like the trees and the vegetation. So basically there is a distinction between the quality of the mana between the fauna and the flora. Fauna and flora. Okay, about the mana stream, do you want to read it? Yes, yes, yes. Okay, more than the Demon Knight, nature mana. What? D'accord. When a Demon Knight forcefully gets the power from nature, it takes it from something called the mana stream. I don't understand what. The books are contradicting. How do you say that? Contradicting. Yeah. They contradict. They contradict. No, voilà. No, they contradict. They contradict each other. Voilà. D'accord. About the mana stream. D'accord. So the mana stream is used by both the vegetation and the people. Okay. So voilà. The living creatures and the nature are together using the mana stream. Voilà. Basically, if you destroy the mana stream, you destroy life. You know, it is the battery of life. Mochilon. Of course, normal humans. Well, of course, it is not something that can be felt by normal people, normal humans. For this sake, shaman, wizard. Voilà, to be able to manipulate and feel and draw power from the mana stream, the people named the shaman and wizards are using magic, spells. But the Demon Knight is able to draw out the mana from nature without help. Voilà, he's very strong. Voilà, thanks to that he got very strong, and. Voilà, and he's able to use any kind of spell, I guess, the Demon Knight, like, he's a wizard on steroid. Maybe, like, you know, he's both using the magic, the mana that he draws from nature to cast the spells, and also to strengthen his body, I guess. So, he's very, very beefy, both in physical and magical power. Okay, he can, at one glance, the Demon Knight, his behavior is, you could think that, you know, it is for the benefit of people, but... But when you draw out so much mana without a restraint, it will result in instability. And in the worst case, there will be infernos, and there will be fierce winds. The sea will start to engulf everything, and the earth itself will start to crack and break open. Basically, the elements will get out of whack. This planet, voilà. This planet may be destroyed if the Demon Knight is not stopped. Okay. I guess he's going to destroy the mana stream. Okay. About spells and mana, and astral, and the astral. Okay, sure. Let's go and read. No, it's not hard to understand, damn it. Yes, this term, you know, that is basically an English word and so very easy to understand. This term is very hard to explain. So let me explain it by confusing you a lot. Okay, let's see. Voilà, there's words are very hard to understand, but let's see. Mana is... Uh, up. Water. Mana is like a big water. No, water one. It's like a big sea that you can check. I guess I am okay with the conversational Japanese, but yeah, I guess book Japanese is hard. I need to read books. I need to read books. Okay, well, I guess I am reading a book right now. D'accord, so, d'accord, mana is like a big cistern, a water tank, what? But no, mana is what you put into the tank, no? I mean, mana is like the substance, the stuff that is. No, okay, like a spell power that have a big mana tank. You can draw out some a bucket. You see, voilà, it's completely confusing me. Like mana, magical power, astral, even astral. It's about the astral, the magical power, mana. Oh là, d'accord, it's another spiritual power. So astral have nothing to do with mana, it is like a spiritual power. Okay, no, yes, yes, thank you for clarifying. I am completely confused. Okay, about the spells. Okay. D'accord. Basically, spells are able to use mana and pour it into like a fire and water and wind and then make an explosion. Basically, I guess spells are able to change the stuff of a mana to change it to something that would be useful. I guess raw mana is not really doing anything. It's like I don't know, like you know how fuel, but you know you need to put a flame onto it to burn it or explode it to make no interesting stuff happen. Okay, let's see. D'accord. There is also some people that use spells using the astral without using mana. So they, you know, they are using spiritual energy instead of mana. But it's different from mana. So. D'accord, voilà. But astral is very different from mana, because you know, you basically people are powered by astral, so you are always in danger of using your own soul and whatnot, and to die basically. So using astral magic is way 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 more dangerous compared to magic to magical spells, astral spells, magical spells. I don't know how to say that. It's really without a confusion in Japanese, if you don't read the description, of course, because the descriptions are really confusing. But you know, the words themselves, they are very delimited, but you know, there is not enough words in English to... Okay, let's see. D'accord. The death of living creatures and mana. Do you want to read it? Yes. Living creatures... wait. The mana that reside in living creatures upon their death return to the atmosphere, no, flow to the atmosphere, and then the. Voilà, but it does not flow all at once upon dying. It slowly get out from the body. Okay. Even if the body itself is completely destroyed, it changes nothing. The mana still stay in the place of the destruction and you know flow out slowly. Voilà. Before long, the mana that flow from the dead body or the dead place of the body is going back to the is joining with the mana stream. Voilà, and become one together with it. The mana stream, voilà, the mana that become one with the mana stream. Inga, kind of. Inga is like no, it's a cause and effect. Voilà. No, wait, it's a fate. Wait, I guess it's the same. Cause and effect, and no, it's Inga. Inga. Voilà, cause and effect and the karma fate. Okay, so it's all of that. D'accord, basically, the mana that become one with the mana stream is purged of all fade and and become a simple mana. Basically, you know, it it lose any trace of what it was before, you know, like a human or a rabbit or whatnot. But sometimes. Voilà, but sometimes before the mana can flow out of the body, something happens, and it is the soul is tied to the body, and so that's how a monster is born. Oh yes, of course. We saw that with the squirrel. You know, the squirrel died, but he became a monster. No, so he was not really undead. He was, or maybe like all monsters are technically undead, but they are not. No, like they are. I don't know. Whatever. Okay, Chica. D'accord, basically, the strength of the monster have nothing to do with the weakness or strength of the creature before dying, but only with the density of mana. Ok? So, je crois que c'est dessus. D'accord. D'accord. If a human is cut away from a direct contact with the mana stream, there is no doubt that they can become monsters. Voilà, it seemed. Voilà. So basically, it's not really. D'accord. D'accord. I guess what makes a monster is the lack of contact with the mana stream. Not really dying. Okay. But I guess when you die, it's much more easier to break the link between the living creature and the mana stream. Something like that, yes, probably. Okay. So the energy, the soul energy. Do you want to read it? Bon, let's ignore that. D'accord. The energy of all humans, the source of all energy of humans is soul energy. Whatever. D'accord, basically anything that live have a soul, ok? What? I have no idea, but I think that basically a soul and body are the same. So if something have no body, then they have no soul, and so they don't exist. I don't understand. So what, a ghost, immaterial ghost cannot exist? Is that it? Is that what they are saying? But you know, there is this dead fetus that monsters that and they seemed immaterial. Therefore. Therefore, the so-called body, it has no existence. I don't understand why. No, d'accord. Basically, all of that is basically a way to say that the souls are immaterial. I think that is that. Yeah. Okay, I don't know. What? D'accord. The demon people that are able to withstand being able to being. The demon people that are able to withstand having their mana eaten, they are comparatively a new existence. So basically, they are a new stuff. They were not really existing before. And and it seems like they are able to withstand having their mana eaten due to their abnormally compared to humans, abnormally high and strong. Soul energy. So basically, they have very strong souls, the demon people. Okay. Mitsuki is like, no, it's not density. Eh? No. It is Mitsuki. So what it is like a Mitsetsu? Mitsetsu. Okay. Mitsetsu. Voilà, Misetsu. Related, okay. D'accord. There is a link between between mana and what are we talking about? It's soul. Voilà. There is a link between mana and soul. Something that have that don't have a soul. D'accord, voilà, something that don't non. D'accord, a soul that have no contact with, that have no link with mana result in monsterification. Ok. So basically, even, well, of course, voilà, even without a body, there is a monster that can be born as long as the soul, the lump of mana is cut away from mana. No. I guess, like, in this context, mana was a synonym for mana stream. I don't know. Okay, let's see. So the wait, the wall of protecting wall of a magic what? Boheki. Oui, voilà, wall, protecting wall, the protecting wall of mana, like what, literally, or for the sake of protecting, for the sake of using spells, you need to draw out the mana, okay? From what is that? From a magnetic place, like maybe like a fey line, fey lines, maybe Jiryoku, I guess. Voilà. It's a magnetic, I think. Voilà, magnetic and the bar place. Magnetic field, ambiance, atmosphere, focal point. D'accord. For the sake of using magic, the wizard draw out mana, and upon doing that, it is forming a magnetic field around him. This magnetic field is protecting the wizard as a wall would. Okay, so basically, it is like it is a mana shield, I guess. D'accord. The more mana you draw out, the more powerful the shield is. And what? I have no idea. I guess when you take steps to use the magic as an offensive magic, then. What, like, can you give no, basically, I guess, voilà, basically it's a way to protect yourself. Maybe it's not a way, like, it's automatic. It is protecting yourself when, maybe that's why Leone is not, sometimes, you know, she's not suffering any damage, because she cast a spell just before, and so she has some kind of a shield. Maybe, like, it's a fixed damage shield, like, you use, like a spell that use like, I don't know, 50 mana, and you have a shield that can absorb 50 damage. Maybe that's why, that's what is happening. I am not. D'accord. I guess when wizards are casting spells, since they are in a trance, it's hard to for them to protect themselves. This trance. What? I'm getting, you know, like, I'm getting really self-conscious that it's really hard to understand. But why? Is it me or is it just a bad writing? I don't know. I guess I'm not strong. I'm not good enough to understand. Okay, considerable. I don't understand. Considerable mental. Show something. I don't know. But what? Like it is? What? Sentience? No. Ah, I'm dumb, d'accord. Shomo. Shomo ou Ok, I was thinking of something totally different, sorry. D'accord. Ok, so it is. D'accord, when you are in a trance status, it is exhausting your mental enormously. Ok? Understand. So basically, when the monsters destroy the magical shield that was formed when you cast a spell, your magical power, your spells get stronger, is that it? Why? Maybe because the mana that was used, that should be used into the shield, cannot, because you know, it's, the shield is destroyed, so it's put into the spells, so the spells get stronger? I don't know. So basically, you cannot. There is no one that is practicing such things, because if such things happen, then what? I have no idea. Basically, like if the shield is being broken, basically you die just after that. So it's not really it's not possible to train that to train it. I don't understand. Okay, I completely don't understand. What was that? I have no idea. I'm trying to think about it, but it makes no sense. It makes no sense, I don't understand whatever. Okay, so let's see. Monsters and voilà. The relationship between monsters and the demon people. Okay, and monster people and demon people. Okay, just see right now. About pure mana, it is abnormally unstable. Okay, I guess voilà. Pure mana is very unstable. I guess it wanted to get to assume a form, I guess. D'accord, basically, only by using magic, magical spells, and exhausting your mental quite a lot, can you use such a mana, I guess. Voilà, but if you are not prepared, voilà, if living creatures are touched by such pure mana, without, you know, using it through spells, they will become monsters, okay. And then monsters. Voilà, and then voilà, their soul will be eaten by the mana, and d'accord. So that's why the demon people are not able to use magic so easily, because their soul is strong enough to withstand the consumption of mana by mana, I guess. No, the consumption of their soul by mana, I guess. Maybe like the pure mana wants to eat the soul, because the soul is basically the stuff of mana. And I guess just like you know, like when someone dies, their mana join back with the mana stream. All mana wants to join with each other. Is that it? Maybe like that's how the mana stream was formed. Maybe at the start, the planet was suffused by mana all over the place, but you know, it concentrated, until it formed the mana stream. I don't know. Ok, let's see, c'est. Voilà. D'accord, basically, voilà. The souls that are eaten by the mana, I guess, means that the creature is doomed to remain in the world. About the souls that have nobody. About the souls that have nobody, when they are eaten by mana, then they will. Wait, what? Voilà, I guess voilà. It is easier for souls without a body to become stronger monsters, since the strength depends on the density. And without a body, it's easier to have more and more density of mana, I guess. I think that is that. Voilà, when you vanquish, at the time when you vanquish monsters, the stronger the monster, the. What? What? Seriously? But d'accord. When you kill a monster, the only thing that it does is creating a monster even more powerful. Ah yes, of course. Because you know, when monsters die, you know, their souls can suffer the same process of monsterification. But I guess they get stronger. Okay, so basically, like you know, like when 100 monsters die, there is a 20 that become monsters again. But stronger monsters compared to the precedent monsters that died. Something like that. Okay, okay. So wow, it's quite dangerous. Maybe that's how the demon people were formed. You know, they were monsters that were killed again and again until they became super strong. Voilà. Et voilà, c'est voilà, c'est voilà, the stronger. Voilà. Je sais ça. Fleidia, Aistos. Ah oui, Fleidia. Voilà, they are gods. Hein. Gods, yes. I have no idea, but I guess I guess this mechanism was made by Fledia and Aistos for the sake of having strong monsters. I have no idea why would you want that? Manano. D'accord. Voilà. D'accord. The beings that are able to withstand having their mana eaten are called demon people. The demon people are an existence that is way closer to mana compared to humans, and. Voilà, thanks to that, they are able to use magic much more powerful compared to humans. The demon people, voilà, the demon people are not actually pure evil, but their capacity for destruction is unparalleled. You know, they can destroy very easily. So aside from the demon people. D'accord, voilà, the demon people are not really pure evil, but due to their immense power, they think of themselves as superior to anyone that is not a demon people, and so they are working to the destruction of the anything that is not a demon people. Why? I wonder. Now, why would you do that? Let's see, D'accord. The relationship, hierarchy of the demon people. Presently top. D'accord. The leader of the demon people right now is the demon knight. The demon knight is assembling mana for the sake of resurrecting the demon king. We think such. So that's why. Voilà. And below him, there is 7 demon people that I high rank. The 7 Namakusa, what is that? Okay, you know, it's like maybe like Shio. No, wait. What is like the Elite 4? Elite 4 is like how to say that? Like the 4 King, I guess. Voilà, Shitenno. I wonder what it is. Like, there must be a story in Buddhism or whatnot, or Shinto. But yeah, okay, that's Shitenno. And voilà, Nanakusa. What is that? Nanakusa. The 7 spring flowers, the 7 fall flowers, the 7 autumn flowers, the 7th. Okay, so what is that? I am again. Voilà, basically, the 7 generals are called the 7 flowers. Among the demon people, they are the ones that have the highest magical power. Aside of course from the aside the Demon Knight, of course. What? So basically, no, it's a Kyohaku? No. How do you say that? Nigiru. It's Nigiru again. The second one is Nigiru, which is Haku, not Haku, d'accord. So it's a Kyohaku, not a, but yeah, but no, it's not Kyo. Okay, what is that? I don't know. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. The thing Haku, catch understanding. It's from the point of view of the ones that have written, written that, and he must be a human. Okay, let's see. So, in truth, the behavior of the Demon Knight is easy to understand, but the behavior of the Demon People is, you know, and things that are not able to have their mana eaten, we cannot understand their device. Basically, they are, they are beyond understanding, okay? Why? Voilà, the demon people don't really need, desire the world, you know, they don't really want to, what? They have no desire for getting out of, I was thinking they have no desire for the conquest of the world, but maybe it's not that, I don't know. Maybe like, you know, they wanted to keep to themselves, is that it? Yes. No. Ah, d'accord, it is just say promotion, desire for promotion. D'accord, I guess the random, the normal demon people don't really care about the climbing, the hierarchy, but the seven flowers are different. D'accord. Basically, there is almost no rank among the demon people except for the seven generals. So when someone wants to be once a demon people is a little too ambitious, he aim to kill, I guess, as one of the seven flowers. Is that it? No, basically, the only way to get a better rank is to just challenge the seven flowers, the seven generals. I am not kidding. Oh, d'accord. Now let's start with the one. Okay, let's see. Iki, like the Iki is like the ideal, the moral. No, the meaning. D'accord. The meaning of the existence of the demon people. Okay. Several long years. D'accord. The long research of someone that dedicated their lives to study the demon people revealed some new things, some new findings. The demon people, their destructive power. No wait, Hakaishin? A destruction god. What? No. Belonging to spring. What? What is this way of what belonging to the spring? Ah no, it's not spring. Okay, it's, well, there is a spring inside it, but it's not. What is this kanji? No, it's not. Wait, what? Ah, okay, it's almost okay. So how do I form that? I have no idea. Okay, I need to do it from the start. Okay, so let's see. Me. Okay, I guess. Is it enough to find it? No, it's not there. Why? I don't know. Let's see. that, maybe? Please work. It's not working. Okay, how do I find this kanji? I have no idea. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11. Okay. 11 strokes. Okay, 15, too much. 14, 13, 13, 12. Okay, 11. So, let's see. Okay, that thing. What is that? Look around. What? Kaeri miru. Kaeri miru ken. So it is a ken, kenzoku. What is that? Look around. Belonging to the look around. What? Follower, retainer, underling. Okay. D'accord. So I guess it makes a perfect sense. You just need to understand what it means. So belonging to the look around means the follower, retainer, underling, dependent, family. So basically, voilà. The demon people are the followers of the god of destruction. The god of destruction, for the sake of destroying the world, is need pounds, I guess. The body, voilà. The demon people themselves, they are an existence abnormally close to mana, and it's quite plain and quite evident that they are completely different living creatures compared to humans. But the demon people, d'accord. But there is some demon people that are cooperating with humans, and humans that cooperate with demon people, I guess. About the demon people, voilà. Concerning the demon people. Donc voilà. About the demon people, the demon king is absolute. At the time of the destruction of the demon king, the mana that resided in the demon king. What? Why is it a question? So I guess it's an hypothesis. Voilà. Voilà. Among the, voilà. For the demon people, the demon king is absolute. So when the demon king is dead, maybe they are searching for the mana that was dispersed, you know, according to my research, the demon people are able to bestow a magical power on other people. Voilà, but it is not able to, and you are not able to refuse it or remove it. Like basically, once you receive the magical power from the demon people, you cannot remove it. Okay. So why? I do not understand. So why? Basically, the demon king is something that can have its mana eaten, its magical power eaten. Basically, you can only make a demon king by having multiple demon people pour their mana into someone that is not a demon people. Is it? I have no idea. I don't understand. But I'm sure. But what is interesting is that upon the destruction of the new lord, the original world lord will return. What? Okay, so basically, when you pour the mana of the demon king into someone, it's not really that one that becomes a demon king, but you know, the demon king that possesses the body of the one that was poured into. Okay, so basically, something like that, I guess. Basically, it's pseudo immortality. Yeah, it's kinda like a Diablo and the soul gem. You know, when you put the soul gem into your body, you lose yourself. You know, basically, you become Diablo, and Diablo become you. You know, like D'accord. The people that are touched by the natural mana. Wait, what? No, d'accord. The magical power of the people that are touched by natural mana. are towards nature. What? They're really need to use like virgule and whatnot, like, you know, like a way to delimit the sentences, but because like, is it all of that one sentence? Because if it is like one sentence and then that, it's completely different. I think that, you know, the Japanese think that is just a point, no, an emphasis, no, to point, to give you the understanding that, you know, this sentence is actually important. No, it's not it's not an emphasis, it's to end the sentence. Then I have no idea. No, it must be one sentence. I just say the crap. So what? When the demon people are bestowing magical energy on someone, it's natural energy? Is that it? Because it makes no sense. The people that are touched by magical energy. The magical energy of the people that became monsters due to the magical energy bestowed by the demon people, it returns to these demon people. It makes no sense. I don't understand. What? Like, if you remove the first one, it makes sense. You know, like the magical power that is bestowed by two people that become monsters by the demon people, return to the demon people once the monster dies. I mean, it makes sense. You know, it's their own mana to begin with. So, you know, like aside from going to the mana stream, it goes to the demon people. Okay, fine. But what is that? What? I don't understand. Whatever. Who cares? Okay. Who cares? I do care. I want to understand. That's it. Wait, what's all? 52 minutes. Okay, I guess. Sorry, I didn't really see time pass. Well, according to this example, we can understand that the demon people are an existence that is close to nature. I don't know what? Basically, when a natural being, a beast. No, it makes no sense. I don't understand. In other words, the demon. The mana of the demon king that was vanquished 30 years ago, even now, it is residing in living creatures. And when you destroy these creatures, the original demon king will return and he will probably resurrect. Is that it? I don't understand. What? Well, this is Sasuke Kotode. But what does it mean? Ah, yes, of course, because even if there is nobody, the mana can still. I don't know. Like, I don't know, but I guess the body of the Demon King must go get back the mana that was. Voilà. So basically, I guess the Demon King, the Demon people are working to kill anything that received the mana from the Demon King, and so that the Demon King can be resurrected. I guess when they say that the Demon Knight assemble mana, is actually that killing things until all the mana from the Demon King is found, I guess. Voilà, now that we. D'accord. If my hypothesis is correct, this existence of the Demon King is terrifying for us humans. Because the Demon people. Voilà, because the demon people will not stop until all the living creatures of all the planet are destroyed. Okay? Yes, indeed. Will I remember that? Yeah, whatever. Let's read that. It's a 55 minute limit. I need to stop. Okay, so I hope you liked it. Yes, it was a little thrilling. I'm sorry. But, you know, I'm not good. If I was good, I would not do these videos. It's quite a paradox. To have good videos, the only people that would do these videos, the only reason I do these videos is because I'm not good. And once I'm not good, and so, you know, it's more agreeable to listen to these videos, I will not do these videos. So, yeah. Basically, the only videos that I can do are bad videos. I'm sorry. But yeah, I have at least a good 1 or 2 years in front of me before being good enough to be fluent. Okay, goodbye. Yes, no, what I knew. Okay, so I hope you liked it. If you liked it, don't forget to check the description of the video. There is a link to my playlist of games that I have already done. And see you next time. Bye bye. Au revoir.